This video is sponsored by Magellan TV. In 2002, the United States was facing one of the worst wildfire seasons in the last half century. Hundreds of thousands of acres burned in Colorado. Aside from brave firefighters, the U.S. Forest Service depended on a 33-aircraft fleet to combat the fires. But two fatal accidents grounded the fleet, leaving the country without air power to deploy against the ruthless flames. The Boeing 747 Supertanker was explicitly built to fill in and save the day. Initially a passenger plane, it was modified by Evergreen International Aviation to become the world's largest fire extinguisher. This massive air tanker can carry almost 20,000 gallons of fire retardant and spread it across an area as big as a football field. The company also claims that the supertanker is so fast that it can reach any point in the world in less than 20 hours. Since its inception, the 747 has fought fires in Colorado and California. The supertanker has also helped extinguish massive forest fires in Bolivia, Chile, Mexico, and Israel. Although the jumbo jet was grounded for a couple of years due to Evergreen's serious financial difficulties, it managed to return to operations. Nowadays, it's one of the most potent human tools against the wildfires that afflict the world year after year. At the dawn of aviation, few could have imagined the tasks that airliners would eventually perform. Aviation's current capabilities are astounding, but it was a long and dangerous path to get there. Learn more about the sacrifices made and challenges met along the way in the Magellan TV documentary 100 Years of Aviation. Magellan TV is a new type of documentary streaming membership created by filmmakers that brings over 3,000 documentaries to all of your devices. Visit try.magellantv.com/darkskies or click the link in the description below to get a free one-month trial. Magellan TV is also offering a buy one, get one free annual gift card, and purchasing a gift card any time of the year will also give you an additional month at Magellan TV for free, even if you're already a member. Now's the perfect time to share Magellan TV with your friends and family. Visit try.magellantv.com/darkskies today and click on the banner to take advantage of this limited offer for Dark Skies viewers. Filling the gap. In 2002, a Lockheed C-130 Hercules and a consolidated PB-4Y-2 privateer were involved in two different fatal accidents while carrying out their firefighting duties. The air tankers were part of a 33-aircraft fleet responsible for combating one of the worst fire seasons seen in the U.S. during the last half century. In June, the Hercules wing separated from the aircraft due to a structural failure while flying over California. The three crewmen on board were lost. 1 month later, the privateer's left wing folded upwards while on its way to drop retardant on a fire in Colorado. The airplane crashed, taking the lives of both crew members. These two events prompted the grounding of the entire fleet, which had to be inspected for maintenance issues. Due to safety concerns, the U.S. government canceled the contract on 9 air tankers and retired 11 Beechcraft 58P Baron lead planes. 1 year later, all large air tankers were withdrawn from service from the U.S. Forest Service. Suddenly, the country was out of critical aircraft used to fight wildfires. And so the U.S. Department of the Interior issued an official request for information on modern air tankers that could replace those that had been retired. Evergreen International Aviation presented a bold proposal. They would modify 4 of their Boeing 747s and equip them with 24,000 gallons of retardant, which could be dropped effectively over any fire in any part of the world. Until then, the largest air tanker was the C-130, which could only carry up to 5,500 gallons of retardant. The company officially presented the aircraft in mid-February of 2004 to the Anchorage Air Cargo Association. Its size seemed unconvincing to some experts like Joe Stamm, fire program manager for the State Division of Forestry, who thought the 747 was too big for his department. At the time he said, quote, "I don't know if we would use it for an initial attack." Despite advertising the aircraft as the Swiss Army knife of emergency response, Evergreen had to wait 2 years to get a certification from the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration. They also had to wait the same amount of time to obtain an evaluation from the U.S. Forest Service. Finally, in 2006, the 747 was certified for the aerial dispersal of liquids. Largest fire extinguisher. Development of the supertanker, better known as the world's largest fire extinguisher, went as high as $50 million. While other air tankers just made one big single drop over a fire, the supertanker has an innovative pressurized liquid drop system. The equipment allows it to make precision drops of water or ammonia-based retardant at the speed of falling rain. The spraying system keeps cars and trees safe from damage and allows the plane to drop retardant in areas that are difficult to access, like valleys. It also has the incredible advantage of being completely refilled in only 30 minutes. Evergreen described the aircraft as being as precise and in control as an aerosol can. The 747 can reach a top speed of 600 miles per hour. The company says that the airplane could fly to the opposite side of the world in 20 hours and fly across the continental United States in only 5 hours. It can also slow down to 160 miles per hour to drop fire retardant 300 feet above the ground. The tank of the aircraft was configured to allow for segmented drops. Rick Campfield from Evergreen explained to Wired.com, quote, "This aircraft can lay down a 3-mile-long, football field-wide swath of retardant if needed. There's no close second." Large air tankers like the 747 have a weakness, though. They can't be used through high wind speeds, which can blow away the retardant. However, the plane is extremely effective at building containment lines between the flames and the firefighters. As Global Supertanker Chief Pilot Cliff Hale said, quote, "It's a force multiplier. When you need to build containment lines fast, having that very large capacity can really help the guys out on the ground." Inside, the supertanker carries 14 first-class seats and 2 bunks for the additional flight crew. Aside from its firefighting capabilities, the airplane can spray dispersants on marine oil spills. Flying the supertanker can be challenging for any experienced pilot because its flaps and slats have to remain extended, meaning that the plane is always configured for a landing approach. In 2006, the aircraft was stationed in Sacramento, California, waiting under a call-when-needed contract with the California Department of Forestry and Fire Protection. Rebirth. Evergreen International Aviation faced severe financial difficulties that left the supertanker grounded for years. The company had been built in the 1960s, and besides operating the 747, had found success building commercial helicopters used for agricultural operations. However, in 2012, the company published a statement saying that the U.S. Forest Service had refused to hire the airplane to combat the devastating Colorado wildfires. According to Evergreen, years before that, they had been offered a call-when-needed contract with the government. But the aircraft was never called to action, resulting in a multi-million-dollar loss for the company. After Evergreen implemented an exclusive use contract with the government, the services of the 747 weren't called for again. On November 8, 2013, Evergreen announced to its employees that it would cease operations. 1 year later, it filed for bankruptcy. The 747 airframes were sold at $4 million to a parts salvage reseller to pay for other debt obligations. In 2015, though, the aircraft was given a second chance. Global Supertanker Services, the successor to Evergreen, bought back the 747 assets and intellectual property and transplanted the sprayer system into a new aircraft. Initially a passenger aircraft, the 747-400 is over 29 years old and initially belonged to Japan Airlines, which then sold it to Evergreen. The improved supertanker was nicknamed the Spirit of John Muir after the father of America's national park. It was immediately based out of Colorado Springs. Their long and wide runways are perfect for the airplane to take off. Saving the Amazon. Surprisingly, the supertanker's first assignments weren't in the U.S. It was first leased for 2 missions in Israel. The first one, in 2010, was supposed to help on the Carmel forest fire, which took the lives of 44 people. However, the supertanker arrived too late for the emergency and was practically unusable. For the second mission, in 2016, the aircraft successfully aided in controlling fires north of Jerusalem. In 2017, Chile also used the supertanker to help stop devastating forest fires spreading on its territory. Millionaire Luciana Aviles leased the aircraft to combat over 100 active fires. At first, Chilean authorities didn't believe the 747, considered one of the world's largest aircraft, could make it through the country's mountains. However, Evergreen assured that the 747 operates without any operational, speed, or altitude restrictions. The story of the supertanker's flight to Chile was surrounded by intrigue. Chilean media discovered that the 747 had been abandoned in the Colorado desert, ready to be sold as scrap. Evergreen didn't have the permits to fly the aircraft in the U.S., and a storm had severely damaged the fuselage. Moreover, the company had declared bankruptcy a couple of years before, and the aircraft had failed to live up to expectations in emergencies in Mexico and Alaska. To lease the aircraft to Chile, Evergreen demanded a deposit of $2 million. The whole operation to reactivate and procure the 747 cost $9 million, paid for by wealthy citizens of the country and through a funding campaign. 20 days after the supertanker arrived, the citizens of Chile bid it farewell as a national hero. In 2019, fires ravaged the Amazon tropical rainforest, which stretches through 9 countries in South America. In Bolivia, the fire affected 650,000 hectares, 8 times the size of New York City. To combat the deforestation, Bolivia commissioned the supertanker, which has a leasing fee of $800,000. The 747 arrived in Santa Cruz, in eastern Bolivia, in August of 2019. In 2 months, it completed 61 flights. Every flight of the aircraft was estimated to cost over $16,000. After 100 days of fires, the supertanker and a lucky streak of rain helped control the situation. However, 7 firefighters and hundreds of animal and plant species were lost during the emergency. American firefighter. After overcoming Evergreen's financial debacle, the aircraft was finally assigned missions in the continental United States. In 2017, it was called to California, where in just 1 week, it managed to drop 219,000 gallons of fire retardant in 13 flights. That year, 21 lives had been lost to the wildfires, which ravaged 73,000 acres and 3,500 buildings. The 747 was also recruited during critical times like the car fires and the Mendocino Complex fire in Northern California during 2018. Global Supertanker recognizes that the aircraft doesn't represent an absolute solution to wildfires. However, it is an extremely helpful tool when mixed with smaller aircraft. In 2020, amidst the global pandemic, the supertanker was sent to fight the multiple fires spreading across Southern California. The large air tanker currently only has permission to fly in Colorado, Oregon, and California. However, if needed, it can be deployed to other countries.